My lover's got humor, used to giggle at a funeral. It's everybody's disapproval, should have worshipped her sooner. If the heavens ever did speak, she's the last true mouthpiece. Every Sunday's getting more bleak, fresh poison each week. We were born sick, you heard them say it. My church offers no absolute, she gives me worship in the bedroom. Only heaven I'll be sent to is when I'm alone with you. We were born sick, heard them say it. Commend me to be well. Amen. 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 Take me to church, I'll ship like a dog at the shrine of your lake. I'll tell you my sins so you can sharpen your knife. For me, that deathless death, good God, let me give you my life. Take me to church, I'll ship like a dog at the shrine of your light. I'll tell you my sins so you can sharpen your knife. For me, that deathless death, good God, let me give you my life. I'm a pagan for the good time. My lover's in the sunlight. Keep the goddess on my side. She demands a sacrifice. Drain the whole sea. Something shiny. Something meaty for the main course. That's a fine looking high horse. What you got in the stable? And keep the god a lot unfaithful. That looks tasty, that looks plenty. This is hungry work. Take me to church, I'll ship like a dog at the shrine of your light. I'll tell you my sins so you can sharpen your knife. For me, that deathless death, good God, let me give you my life. Take me to church, I'll ship like a dog at the shrine of your light. I'll tell you my sins so you can sharpen your knife. For me, that deathless death, good God, let me give you my life. No master of sins, when the rituals begin, there is no sweeter innocence than our gentle sins. In the madness and toil that God forsent, only then I am human, only then I am clean. The shrine of your light. I'll tell you my sins so you can sharpen your knife. For me, that deathless death, good God, let me give you my life. Take me to church, I'll worship like a dog at the shrine of your light. I'll tell you my sins so you can sharpen your knife. For me, that deathless death, good God, let me give you my life.
Thank you.
As a song by a great artist called Hozier called Take Me to Church. I'm going to try something that I have not played in a very, very long time. I was asked to play this one. Sue asked me to play this one, so I do this for you. This song was from my debut album, which was released in August. It turns 10 years old, which is just mad to think. I was probably about 9 when this one came out. I wrote this song originally. I got an older sister, a few years older than me. I wrote this song when, for the first time, she started talking to my parents about the idea of her moving away from home. And I could just see this immediate worry and fear in my parents' eyes, and also the realization that she was growing up, and that it was happening all a bit too fast. And it got me thinking at the time about how that must feel as a parent to see your children grow up. I ended up writing this song. So I'll give it a go now. It's only you guys that know this, so if I completely screw it up, keep your poker faces, all right? Good, how does it feel? They have broken the mold, blossomed into objects that have become harder to hold. He's your only son. He hopes to make you proud of the man that he's sure to become. And she has bloomed to your girl. You have the ambition for her to try and conquer this world. But how does it feel to see how does it feel to see them at the door and wave goodbye. Kiss them at the door and wish them luck, 'cause we all grow up with you. You've been here before with your bag, beer and fags. You decided you'd sneak out the door. Oh, but they stay to watch you grow, gritted their teeth as you became someone they didn't know. Yeah, but you gone through those days, and they're proud of you now, and they hope that you'll stay this way. So how does it feel to see? Yeah, how must it feel to see children grow and face the world? How does it feel to watch them grow? How must it feel one day I may know? I'd kiss them at the door and wave goodbye. Kiss them at the door, wish them luck, 'cause we all grow up. Thank you. Thank you. I'm gonna try a new song on you guys, if that's okay. So, I come from the city of Canterbury. I was born in a house just on the outskirts of that city, and then I got my education there, and I still live there to this very day. So through default of being in the same city, the same place for all my life, I know a lot of people. I feel very blessed to know a lot of people that live in the city of Canterbury. There's also a whole lot of people in that city that I wish I didn't know. And this is about those situations. Every one of us in this room has had one of these situations. Let me explain. You're doing something with your day, something mundane, you're doing your shopping or something, and you lock eyes with someone that you know, and instead of thinking, oh, there's so-and-so, brilliant, let's go have a chat, your internal thought goes, ah, bollocks. Because you know you've got to have one of those terribly awkward conversations of just small talk, and I suck at small talk, so it's always a fear for me. And it lasts all of about a minute, but it feels like a lifetime. And I hate that. And that happens a lot just again through going to school, going to college and being there my entire life. But it's one of my favourite things to see friends of mine in this situation and seeing how they dart their way around those awkward conversations and small talk. It's like boxing, you know. It's fun to watch, but I want no involvement in it. And it stopped happening through COVID. I was going on all of these long walks, and it got to a point where I was longing to bump into someone that I recognised just for a bit of small talk. And with that in mind, I ended up thinking of all these bizarre scenarios that you could possibly bump into people and who these people might be from your past and all of that. And I just thought, well, there's a good idea for a song. So I wrote this. It's called Old Friends. Down by the shore, just skimming stones, when somebody said my name, someone I did not know. Well, at least I did not recognize the smile aimed at me. Oh dear. He said we studied together way back when in 2003. His hair had all fallen out and his teeth were all stained green. He was sucking on a cigarette and his coffee was taken black. So it made sense. Why does it always feel so intense? Bumping into old friends. Well, I was standing in my local, just waiting on Whitley Neal, when somebody hissed my name in a voice harsh and shrill. Well, this face I did indeed recognize, yet I would be a fool to forget the regret. Well, I did not ask how she was holding up. I knew she was no fan of mine, but I thought she'd let me off. Oh, but she stood and stared so deeply that it burnt down to my soul. Oh no, why does it always feel so intense? Bumping into old friends. Well, I'm sat in traffic, stuck behind the wheel. Bought a faster car so I could just sit still. Well, she rolled down her window next to me and she started to squeal. Hello there. She said I was your teacher way back when you were just a boy. Your hair was so much longer, you were shorter, you were a joy. I said I do not care to reminisce about the days that I do not recall myself. Farewell. Why does it always feel so intense? Bumping into old friends. Thank you.
I packed up all my bags and I recently moved home. Walking through these streets, no one looks up from their phones, and I can't recall the last time that I didn't feel alone and low. Round here the streets are paved with grey, and it rains here every day. There's no smile found on a face of a person in this place. And I hate to be a hypocrite, I hate to be wrong again, but I'd love to of you intense and bump into an old friend. Yeah, I'd love to feel intense and bump into an
thank you very much.